ask you a couple things about your contact with the Cavs at the combine.
Yeah.
Do you remember anything about that?
Yeah, so I talked with them at the combine. It was a good talk. I think instead of being 20 minutes, it was about 30 minutes. And the first thing they showed me when I got in was the new rink, the new setup. Bill Armstrong just talked to me about all of that, about him being accepted. And then it was just such a good talk. And they showed me so much interest, too. So it was just like being fluid. And it was nice, too.
What did you tell them about yourself?
Well, the type of defenseman I am, that's for sure. You're not going to see a lot of 6'7 defensemen who's going to have a mean streak like me and who's going to has such a good skating. So that's definitely something. Well, they already knew it because they saw me the whole year, and just me telling them. And also they want to see me as a person, how I was too. So just always with my big smile and my good energy. So that's something.
We've heard that about you,
I know, and that's something that they liked about me, I think so.
Did you see the highlights that they were showing of you?
I didn't have time, no. I have no idea what
Speaking
they showed.
Of your physical play, yes. They showed you destroying a couple players.
Yeah. I don't know if maybe they showed the window I broke too. I don't know, but I'm probably going to watch it in a couple of days after that.
What do you know about this franchise at this point? Any players, any of the executives, do you know anything about it?
Well, I know the coach. I know their young organization. My mom, she went there for work a bit too, so I know it's hot. It's a desert. There's a lot of scorpions and things like that there. But I know a couple of things about the team. And well, just being there and just going to the development camp and seeing all the other guys and going to the camp and just seeing everyone, it's going to be so fun.
Do you have a history with Andre?
With who?
Andre Tourigny?
No. Okay. No, I don't.
Okay.
Yeah.
Maverick, what does this feel like to be drafted in the first round? Did you see yourself going in the first round, and what are you feeling right now?
Well, of course, I wanted to go in the first one. It was one of my main goal, but I didn't know until I got drafted. But when I got drafted, when I heard my name, it was just such a good feeling. My legs dropped. I couldn't believe it at first. And I just, as of even now, I'm just so happy. Like, I can't even describe it with words. It's the best day of my life, that's for sure.
You talk about being a big, imposing defenseman.
Yeah.
How did you develop that style? Was it, did you grow into your size, or what made you develop that mean streak on the ice?
I think all the cross check came from when I played lacrosse, and I think I kept that from that. But I think all my mean side and physical, it's been a big part of me. And my dad was like that when he played hockey too, so I think he gave me that growing up.
What types of things do you think you still need to work on and develop that you'll focus on before you make the big league
level? I think definitely I'm going to play against adults, so I got to get bigger. I'm tall, but I'm not as big. So I got to put on some weight, but also definitely all my puck handling and my low skill sets, it's going to be so much better too at the NHL. So that's those two main aspects I got to work on to get there.
Thank you.
Good.
What's your path look like going forward?
Pardon?
Like next year, what does your path look like?
Well, next year, I think it's going to go well to going back to Drummondville, and then we'll have a better team going longer in playoff and maybe go win. So I think next year is going to be to going back to Drummondville.
Maverick, nice meeting you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.